£1.1 million, of which we've been granted just over £600,000.
This goes to Julia.
Did you sort of feel that you had to go away and do lots of research around the topic? Did you feel that the script sort of stood on its own for you in terms of giving you enough for the character?
I always like to do lots of research, so yeah, I did. And you have a huge responsibility when you're playing somebody who not only existed, but you know their flesh and blood are still alive. And so you try your very best to inhabit somebody in as truthful a way as you can, I think, even more. You know, so I did lots of research. Unfortunately, Julia is very underrepresented in all of the biographical work of Lennon. So I had to do a lot of work myself. Julia Baird's book is brilliant because it's full of the sort of mundane minutiae that actors love. You know, just silly wee anecdotes and lovely moments and details.
It's just a wonderful story, and that's what matters to me from it, and it was really powerful. And I'm just interested with you when you talk about doing so much research. How much at the end of the day it really is about the story, and the facts at the end of the day are not as important as the essence of the story.
I think that's true, and also you have a screenplay which you have to obey, so you can only do so much work, you know, and then you have to say, well, that's that woman, but this woman who lives within the world of the script, you know. But yeah, you just pray by osmosis, somehow all of this information you have gleaned will just be within you, and then you get on with telling the story and you pray to Jesus that it will somehow be evident.
Yeah, there's a question just up there.
I'd just like to ask, is it true that Lennon's father did go to New Zealand? Is that what happened?
Yeah, it's a phenomenal... Oh, you should read Julia's book, actually, because it explains the holy all of it, and there is such a great story there. His story is amazing, because he did. He went off to war. Julia didn't hear from him for 3 years at a time. And then he would come back and expect, you know... And then she would be judged for having found somebody else in her life. It was just ghastly. And then he decided, and he did take John off to Blackpool for the day, he was going to take him to New Zealand. And that's where he ended up, his dad, in New Zealand. Because he was in the Navy, you know, after he went. But yeah, so he didn't really have any relationship with his father, terribly sad.
Sam is very comfortable on the set because she's made video installations, also music videos. She's done tons of those. So she's kind of at home working with the DOP, and she already had a very strong relationship with Seamus McGarvey, who's just the most amazing DOP. You know, we were really lucky to have him. So she has a phenomenal amount of confidence, and I don't mean that in a swaggering way or anything, but she has this real sense of, fuck it, who knows? And so... I think that is what she brought to work every day. And although she may have not been on our case, you know, we weren't under a microscope in terms of what we were doing. She kind of left it up to us, so at times that was completely terrifying. Especially when you're playing a character like Julia with such huge character choices, you know. But still she sort of went, well, I have the confidence in you to do your job. That's what I expect you to do. So in a way it's empowering, as well as completely terrifying.
Did you do rehearsals?
We had a wee bit of rehearsal, but really in film, rehearsals always tend to be just about establishing the space between people, you know, so that when you're on set, you have already gotten over the first awkwardness, you know. Because if you over-rehearse film, unless it's an improvised or devised piece in which that's an absolutely necessary part of the process, but it doesn't stand up to that sort of fresh, you know, it's not fresh. And it's so very much in the moment. because of course with theatre you rehearse and rehearse and rehearse and you go beyond every, you know, you go into a different realm. You don't have the chance to do that with film, so you need it to be really immediate.
Forget the cash, what about the art? Give us a verdict on the art.
Are you worried about buying drinks? I'll buy you drinks.
Una, verdict on the art.
I might well be.
Leave the money. What did you think?
What do you want me to say? Anne-Marie Duff is a creative inspiration. I love her. She's why we go to the cinema.
That would do.
And John Lennon wasn't half bad either.